Wish them the happy life.
So thank you so much for the presentation. I'm an economist, so everything is new for me. So I come from Brazil, and I have almost a stupid question. I'm sorry for that.
No problem.
But thinking about the destruction of Amazon, I was thinking about, I understand very poorly why Amazon is so important for the world when it comes to biodiversity. Why it's so different from other places? And even if we stop it altogether, the deforestation is starting, I don't know, regenerating the trees and planting, what would happen? It will like at least help something?
Oh, yes. Oui, d'accord. Alors, so we have the same question, more or less, or no?
No.
Well, I answer. Okay. Alors, why is it so important for Amazonia? First of all, it is because we have destroyed the forest elsewhere. Well, it's a bad answer, but it's a reality. The second answer is that in tropical areas, for many reasons, we have very high biodiversity compared to temperate situation, for example. If you take a tropical forest, you can have per hectare more than 1,000 species. It is never the case in a temperate forest. So clearly, a part of the total of the global biodiversity is located in tropical areas. After that, what we do in Amazonia, for me, is not only the destruction of the forest and of biodiversity. It is also the destruction of soils, and more, it is the destruction of the logic of the system. I try to explain. When you go in Amazonia, I don't really know Amazonia, but I know what it is, but I also work in West Africa, comparable conditions. You have soils, sandy soils. In sandy soils, you have no clays. When you have no clays, you have no capacities to accumulate humus, organic matter, and mineral nutrients. And what happens for plants in this condition? Because there is nothing in the soil. In fact, plants create their whole organization leading to the recycling of nutrients and soil. In temperate area, for example, you have in most situations, you have clay in the soil, good clays, allowing a high accumulation of carbon and nutrients. So you have a sort of reserve. You have a mine, and the plants exploit the mine. When you go in Amazonia, there is no mine. So in fact, plants organize some parallel circuits, short circuits of nutrients. And so the engine of the fertility is not the soil. The engine of fertility in Amazonia are the plants. So when you destroy the plants, what do you get? You get a sandy soil without reserve. So you make you can cultivate crops during a few number of years, and after that, it is finished. So to reverse the system, you have two solutions. You can try to grow directly some new trees. It's possible. And what is done now, not only for restoration, but also for meat production and so on, you can grow some grasses. And sometimes people use grasses coming from Africa, because these grasses are able to create this short circuit of nutrient leading to an occupant. Voilà, you restore an interactive system. The problem of Amazonia, but it is also true in many areas in Africa, is that you destroy a system based on living organisms. Living organisms create their own environment. This is something we forget. Living forms, living organisms adapt to the environment. But the best way to adapt to a poor environment is to take the control on the environment and to create a particular environment just around the organism. This is what we observe in savannas, in many tropical areas. For example, in Brazil, because I went in Brazil, I visited a plantation of eucalyptus. They wanted to produce wood to make charbon bois, charcoal,
coal,
to make coal for the industry of iron. Okay, it was very funny. It was a very clear sandy soil. You had an accumulation of dead leaves. It's normal. The decomposition of leaves of eucalyptus leaves is slow. And when you look at the basis of this level of trees, of leaves, you took the leaf at the bottom. You look at the face in contact with the soil. You have 80% of the surface of the leaf covered by eucalyptus roots. Clearly, there is a slow decomposition, but there is a decomposition. There is a production of mineral nutrients. These mineral nutrients have 80% chance to be uptaken by the roots, and they come back to the living trees. And in the soil, there is nothing. I have seen exactly the same system in some forests in Normandy, in France. So, once more, we have some bad representation. We say roots grow in the soil. No. Roots grow in the dead organic matter because we have the nutrients here in this organic matter, at least in these systems with high recycling, etc. So, voilà. For me, when you look at soil classification, it's a nightmare. So it's completely, for me, there is two types of soil in the world. There is soil with a good clay, with the reserves, with mining strategy of plants, and there is soil without clays, without reserves, with a short circuit, je ne sais pas quoi, enfin, on dirait ça circuit court en français, short circuit economy, like in economy. You know that probably. There is an economy of reserve and an economy of constant flow, short flow. Voilà. So, I don't know if it's... for me, I see the problem of Amazonia like that. And for example, traditional population in Amazonia, they grow during a few years in a place, and they go to another place, because after a few years, there is nothing to exploit in the soil, because there is no reserve.
Okay, thank you very much for your lecture. I believe this is super important and valuable.